Hi, I'm Yvonne Quisumbing. My solo show at Silverlands is entitled Apothecary Prelude. This is my second solo show at Silverlands. The inspiration behind the Apothecary series is the book Medicinal Plants of the Philippines by Dr. Eduardo Quisumbing, first published in 1951. Dr. Quisumbing was my father's uncle, and he wrote a taxonomy of more than 800 species of medicinal plants. It was supposed to contain several illustrations, but they were destroyed during the liberation along with the Bureau of Science where they were housed. So a few years ago, I picked up the book again and I thought that I'd illustrate some of the plants for reference. But that project evolved into these portraits as personifications of Philippine health, where each portrait represents a certain disease or a health condition indicated by the plants. In Apothecary Prelude, which is about women's ailments, the plants featured here are those that can aid with conception, birth, and recovery after birth. The snake patterns appear on the clothing as well as on the sculptural substrates. The geometric sculpture is a representation of the labid, a snake-like zigzagging tattoo pattern of the Visayan pintados. During pre-colonial times, the snake was said to be both worshipped and feared, and snake bile was used as medicine. So the sculptures here as foundation of these pieces stand for both Philippine heritage and health of Filipinos. What drew me to fashion is the idea that fabrics can be used as medium for art, and also I thought of fashion as sort of a mask where one can project a certain image or a persona using pieces of clothing. And the psychology of one creating persona through clothes intrigued me. With these two things in mind, I pursued fashion design. So in 2005, with the help of a group of talented people, I came up with my first solo show entitled Infernal Desire Machines, where I showcased paintings, clothes, and metal sculptures. And looking back, my intention behind the show was to achieve the idea of fabric as medium and also to explore the concept of clothes as a deliberate persona that can be put on and then shed off. And the atmosphere of the show, which reflects the bizarre shift of awareness that clothes are no longer the innocent basic need but something that can control and persuade perception. What made me shift from fashion to painting? It was a long and gradual transition. Until 7 years ago, I set up a room, sat down, and started to paint. And I've been doing this since then. My discipline in design, I noticed, seeped through my subject matters of headdresses, masks, and cloth figures as if instructions or illustrations to be sewn or put together later on. And I'm intrigued by these recurring themes because of their capacity to move through opposite directions. For example, the masks and clothes can be used to protect and conceal. On the other hand, they can be used to reveal something and provoke. While the snake, which is a universal symbol of good health and medicine, has the potential to deliver death with its venom. So, to interpret these ideas into something tangible, I'm hoping will help me reveal something about their relevance in my life.